back of Express tonight on China's television. Just before we went on that break, I was telling you the beautiful story of Nigeria's under-19 cricket team in South Africa. They want a ticket to the under-19 cricket World Cup, and they're so close to getting it. 3 wins out of 3 matches. And on Sunday, they'll be taking on Tanzania. They win that one, then they are good. Let's go to South Africa. That's where the president of the Nigeria Cricket Federation, Professor Adam Kweya, is standing by to speak to us. We want to know more about these young lads and the exploits they're doing in South Africa. Good evening, President of the Cricket Federation. Welcome to Sports Tonight.
Good evening, my dear.
Okay, good. So
it's wonderful to be talking to you.
Okay, good to have you on the show. Let's talk about what's happening right there in South Africa. It's Tanzania on Sunday for Nigeria's under-19 cricket team. Are they going to beat Tanzania and qualify for the World Cup?
We are hoping so that we'll get the win over Tanzania. No, we're not qualifying. Yes, we're going to qualify from Division 2 to Division 1. And it is from Division 1 we can now fight for the World Cup ticket with bigger countries in cricket, like Namibia, Kenya, and Uganda.
So how are they getting...
The countries that are in Division 1.
How are they getting ready for Tanzania?
Well, we had a friendly match today against Mozambique. And the boys played very well. We batted first and scored 358 runs. This was massive because I mean probably the largest we ever scored in any cricket team match in our history. And Mozambique ended with 91 runs, all out at the end. The advantage of playing the match is that first match, we batted first. We were put to bat first. Well, we started not very well, but eventually finished strongly and eventually beat Ghana also with a wide margin. Other teams sort of didn't want that kind of embarrassment, so they batted first and didn't score too many runs. So our boys didn't get enough batting practice. Batting is the most difficult part of cricket. And you need to be on song if you're going to win. You want to put runs on board before you can defend it. We felt that when we were given the opportunity to play differently, we thought it was a good thing, and then we went for it. And we got the kind of performance we wanted from the boys. Mm-hmm. And then we have today, and we have tomorrow and next tomorrow. That is Friday and Saturday. And the boys will be working hard in the net. I mean, at least we will be training. I mean, we'll be training towards that semifinal match on Sunday because it puts everything in one perspective.
A very very important match day for Nigeria.
Let me get you
talking, because the last time you were here, we talked about grassroots cricket's development, and this is the under-19. We love what we're seeing. You mentioned Namibia, Kenya. Look at that. They are already in Division 1. We're in Division 2. So what are those things that they are doing that we can do with our cricket at this level so that we can start looking at these under-19s and start projecting towards a better future?
Well, the grassroots development is in progress. Now, we are fortunate this year that the national youth game has been brought to under-16 level. That gives us opportunity to see children playing, I mean, to pick out the children early now. And I have already told my colleague that even for the next under-19, we have to start preparing now. And the National Youth Game provides us that opportunity to pick out the talents already from the zonal elimination, which has already taken place. We've already started picking some talent and hoping that by the end of the finals, we will have a pool of talents that we can now put into high-performance programs. Mm-hmm. And so from even right from the National Youth Games this year, we're hoping that within the next 2 years, we will have some boys joining some other reserve players that are on the ground to form the next team. The under-19 process is very important because it provides you the opportunity to bring up young staff who have gone through competition. So they've been tested under pressure. And then it's easy to graduate the best of these boys into the senior team. So it's a very important program for us. What we are planning to do after the National Youth Games is to start running holiday camps for the best of the players selected from the National Youth Games. We'll start running holiday camps in various zones in the country. And maybe we'll take about 10, 15 children at a time in every public holiday. In a particular zone, we'll find suitable camps for those children. And then we have some of the best of our coaches working on the children and preparing them for the next level. And then it's also hoped that at a point, we will start an academy as well. We are at the moment putting together a blueprint for a national academy for cricket. And since we're putting together some facilities in Abuja, part of development program for facilities in Abuja is to put structures on the ground that will support an academy. So these are the programs we are looking up to.
Thank you so much, President of Nigeria Cricket Federation. I want to wish you and the team all the best in South Africa. So that's it. Adam Sukwenya, President of the Nigeria Cricket Federation, are talking to us from that small city called Potchefstroom in South Africa. A good one for cricket developmentalities. And with the things he said, that's the way to go. Hopefully, put words to action.
That's the most important thing. You can do all the planning. If you don't carry out what you've planned, you're going to be in the same spot you were before you planned. So we wait to see what happens next. Though we want to see cricket as a sport develop in Nigeria. Look, I think we need to be able to spread the attention on football. We need to get more involvement in other sports.
Yeah.
Look, football have 95% of the share.
Nothing can touch its followership.
So let us see what happens with other
now
sports.
Take some of the followership of football
and give it. We know football is major.
Yeah.
Can we have people say, oh, after football, my next best sport in Nigeria is cricket, basketball,
rugby,
tennis, all of that. That's what we want because we know football is untouchable in Nigeria, really. But it's good to see that we are not just growing at the national level. It's good to know that at under 19 level, we're making so much progress at the age grade level. I'm surprised, really.
Yeah.
Maybe because I'm paying so much attention to the sports. But this is cricket, and it has this much following at that level. It's good to see kids, teenagers, participating at this early stage and trying to build a career for themselves.
And with that, it's not far from the grassroots. Get cricket players from secondary schools and then let them grow into the under-19s and then the senior national team. Sports Tonight on China's television. It's a fun factory. So let's go to Washington, D.C. Sonny Young is standing by. He's been waiting. Sonny, good to have you on Sports Tonight.
Good evening to you, Austin. It's great to be back on the award-winning Channels Television.
Say
and you're an
again.
Award winner too, Austin. I know that. So
say that
props
again.
To you.
That's right. Thank you so much, Sonny. I saw the joke people. I look at that tie. Almost the same with mine. Sonny's beginning to take a look at the wardrobe before it comes on. Sonny, so much is going on with boxing. The first time we really put eye on Dogbe, it was you that talked about him. That's right. It's okay. It was you that talked about Dogbe, Sonny. He'll be busy again with boxing.
Well, Austin, I love Dogbe's nickname, Royal Storm. Royal Storm. And it kind of fits his style in the ring. He has an attacking style, very fan-friendly. He throws a lot of punches. He is the reigning WBO Super Bantamweight Champion from Ghana. He will be defending his title on Saturday night right here in the United States in the western state of Arizona. Now, some of your viewers might be wondering, Austin, why Arizona? Mm-hmm. That doesn't seem like a typical boxing venue. A lot of championship fights are held in Las Vegas, mm-hmm. some in New York, but I think they're trying to attract the Hispanic crowd there in Arizona, Austin, because on the same fight card as the Dogbe bout, there will be another WBO championship fight between Ray Beltran from Mexico.
That's right.
And he's going to fight this guy by the name of Juan Pedraza
from Puerto Rico.
Another Hispanic fighter from Puerto Rico. So I think they are trying to attract the Hispanic crowd to that card. But I really like Dogbe, Austin.
Yeah.
He's an attacking style, and I think we're going to hear more from him in the years to come.
That's right. That's the name we should keep down. So it's going to take on Otake will feel the Royal Storm.
And Otake, let's not rule him out, Austin.
Yeah.
Very experienced Japanese fighter. Good record, 36 wins, 3 losses. He has a height advantage on Dogbe. But I like Dogbe to defend his title on Saturday.
Yeah, remember when we talked about him in April, then he was fighting JC Magdaleno. We said the same thing. He got that victory. And he's optimistic that he can do the same against Otake. More boxing, Sonny. Fury and Wilder. Now, after that fight and the Tyson Fury, and Wilder came up and was saying all sorts. You know all of this talk before the fight. That should be, in a way, an interesting fight for us also.
I like that fight, Austin. Style-wise, I think it's going to be a very interesting heavyweight fight between the bronze bomber Deontay Wilder and the Gypsy King Tyson Fury. I know that he fought an Italian opponent, Pianetta, last weekend in Belfast. I think he's going to see a lot more movement from Deontay Wilder. Early prediction, Austin. I know you like my predictions.
Yes, I do.
I'm going to go with the bronze bomber. I think he's going to show some movement against Tyson Fury. And hopefully, whether the winner is Fury or Wilder, I hope the winner will face Anthony Joshua.
That's
next.
Right. I don't care who wins. Whoever wins, just give us Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder. We're done waiting. I just want that fight. But, Sonny, aren't you careful? Deontay Wilder has been accused of having no style, no technique. And remember, Tyson Fury took out Vladimir Klitschko. Don't you want to change where you're putting your money?
Well, I sort of agree with you, Austin. I think Fury could pose some problems for Deontay style-wise. Fury, kind of an awkward fighter in some ways, but I don't know. I mean, I think it's going to be wherever that fight is held. I have not heard a venue yet, but I think it's going to draw a lot of attention in the boxing world.
Yeah.
Well, I look forward to it.
I look forward to it also. But remember, I warned you. If you're staying with Deontay Wilder, I warned you. Come back here, Sonny. I'll laugh at you big time. Sonny, let's talk about GGG and Canelo also. We've been waiting for that one. The rematch should also get us talking.
Still a few weeks down the road, September 15th,
right.
the Triple G Canelo rematch, Austin. But the latest news is they named the judges for the rematch.
Mm.
One judge who we will not be seeing ringside for the rematch, Bird. This judge caused controversy. She really had Canelo winning by a wide margin, Adelaide Bird, last year. She will not be invited back for the rematch. Three American judges. This fight so far, Austin, has not received a lot of buzz here in the United States. I'm not quite sure why. I think the media train will pick up in the next few weeks, maybe after these fights coming up. I think we're going to look forward to this one, this rematch between Triple G and Canelo.
Yeah, that doping scandal, Sonny, did a lot of damage to the fight. But just stay right there. I'll come back to you. It's Sports Tonight on Channels Television. Let's go on this break. When we come back, Sonny Young is still with us. We'll grab your rackets. We'll play some tennis. So don't go anywhere. Stay.